be on this side, you know the verses. And then I'll belt out the Teshbuk Tol Morio, praise to the Lord. And then you do congregation two. Again, Teshbuk Tol Morio. You do number one again, okay? Teshbuk Tol Morio. Today we proclaim, blow your sounds of trumpets, and you hosts celebrate. We have come to the harbor, we are prevailed against the strong winds, and reach the safety of our Savior, the shore of our safety.
Of the beloved Son, tell us of Resurrection Day. Tell us of the wonders of our glorious Lord.
Teshbuk Tol Morio.
On the day of the coming into the harbor, how beautiful you are. The crown of precious reward, belong to the just ones. In you old and young rejoice, in you we meet the light and glory, and baptism as a most beautiful bride, filling our souls with eternal light.
Teshbuk Tol Morio.
By faith we are justified, says the Apostle, as a lasting covenant, peace we are given. From strangers to friends, the blood of the crucified one brought nations together. Praise to the Father, who is gracious to us, to the Son who saves us, and to the Spirit who brings life to our celebration.
The next hymn is known as Noro. Noro is just light in Aramaic. This hymn is actually recited and prayed every single morning by the church. It has both the symbolism of our Lord's resurrection, but it is specifically about the day, about judgment, the harrowing of hell. And so you see our Lord bringing light to the dead, among the dead. So you'll see the imagery as you go through it. It is that a part of the Apostles' Creed of the descent into hell that we recite every day and almost never think about. But in the Eastern churches, it's central to the work of redemption of Holy Saturday, because it's the day in which our Lord, into the descent of Sheol, brings redemption to those who have died. So past, present on that day itself of his death and his burial in the tomb. And of course, the future by his resurrection to all of us who are encompassed. That's the meaning behind this hymn. We'll use the same kind of tone that we had the first time. So the refrain you can do together with me, and then again, one, two, one, two.
The light of the just and the joy of the upright, it is Christ Jesus our Lord. Begotten of the Father, he manifested himself to us. He came to rescue us from darkness and to fill us with the radiance of his light.
The light of the just and the joy of the upright is Christ Jesus our Lord.
The day is dawning upon us. The power of the darkness is fading away. The true light there arises for us, the light which illumines our darkened eyes. The light of the just and the joy of the upright is Christ Jesus our Lord. His glory shines upon the world and enlightens the very depths of the abyss. Death is annihilated, night has vanished, and the gates of Sheol are broken.
The light of the just and the joy
creatures lying in darkness from ancient times are clothed in light. The dead arise from the dust and sing because they have a Savior. The light of the just and the joy of the upright is Christ Jesus our Lord. He brings salvation and grants us life. He ascends to his Father on high. He will return in glorious splendor and shed his light on those gazing upon him. The light of the just and the joy of the upright is Christ Jesus our Lord.
What if more not a holy long? Have mercy on us, O Lord, and assist us. O Lord, on the day when you meet, we meet you. Do not extinguish the light of our lamps. O heavenly bridegroom, fill our lamps with the oil of your divine love, that we may remain with you until the end. You are our Lord and our God. To you be glory forever.
Amen.
So we'll do the same here. Alleluia.
Merciful One, open your door to those who shed their tears, as you did for the repenting woman. Be pleased with our sacrifice and accept the penance of our hearts, as you accepted the songs of David the just.
Alleluia.
O Lord, your house we come to find a refuge, a harbor of safety from the sea of evil. Door wide open in the face of those who knock. There is no safety for us besides the safety of your house. Alleluia. O Lord, with your cross, shield your church and her children. Your grace brought them together in blessed choirs to praise you. With the robe of glory bless them, from the evil one deliver them. As a true inheritance, grant them your eternal kingdom.
Now we go up, and when we arrive at the top, the cross-bearer will knock 3 times on the door, and then we'll process back into our places and continue the ceremony in the church. Process in, we'll do Psalm 119 that you have as the hymn of the entrance. Same tone. Keep it simple for the first years. A lamp to my feet is your word, a light to my path.
A lamp to my feet is your word,
So Sugito that you have in the next is one of the styles of the poems. You can sit. Sugito is normally a dialogue hymn. So oftentimes in the Syriac tradition, what they are is recounting oftentimes stories of the saints, the Blessed Virgin Mary and the angel Gabriel for the Annunciation. And so the poet Saint Jacob of Sarug or Saint Ephraim oftentimes will have this dialogue back and forth between the verses. You also have famously one for Good Friday that has the dialogue between the two thieves around our Lord on the day of the crucifixion. So we'll use the same tone for here. Just go halfway through, we do our median, go to the end. So this will be side one, you're on the right side of the church, and side two will be here. Bring your lambs, brothers and sisters, to the day of the Lord has dawned on us. In the shadow of his Eden of light, he rewards generously those who have lived in justice. O Lord of truth, to the just ones, open the door of the garden of delights. Let them meet you in the radiance of light, with their praise and their guitars. The light of our Savior has appeared. Blessed are those who have awaited him. For those who place their hope in him, the Lord of glory prepared a crown of glory. He comes to satisfy their thirst. yet they tremble at his encounter. Oh, how hard was the night of their waiting. Oh, how they long for the name of the coming one. On that day, the greatest of days, all secrets of the heart are revealed. When you come, O Lord, grant us to meet you with the love of a consumed heart. Stamina kalos, Kyrie eleison. May we be worthy to offer praise, glory, and honor to the wise Creator who in his grace brought everything into existence, to the mighty Savior who humbled himself for our salvation because of his love for us, to the harbor of safety in whom the weary ones found rest for their souls, to the calming peace who liberated people from the heavy burdens of the law, to the just one who assumed our nature of sinners in order to save us, to the physician who in his compassion tended to the sick and cured them, to the good one be glory and honor are due in this moment and all the days of our lives and forever. O God, you are the eternal light who enlighten all creatures with the ray of your revelation. You created us in your image. You filled us with the gift of your Holy Spirit. When we had disobeyed your command, we were chased from the abode of life and exiled from your paradise. In your eternal mercies, you had compassion upon us and sent your only Son for our salvation. In his saving and life-giving plan, he showed us the way of life to follow. He became for us a safe guide to the true light. He handed us a new command, the command of love, the yoke of humility, and peace of conscience. In this we found absolute peace for our soul. O Lord, with joyful hearts and peaceful consciences, we walk according to the command you gave us, and with illuminated minds, we give you thanks. We hold our lamps in our hands, we take off our old self, and following your example, we put on the new one. We radiate with your illuminating teachings, and we cross from darkness to the eternal light you have promised us. With the prophet David, we cry out saying, during the day we are enlightened by your teachings, and at night we walk behind you as a column of fire. Our minds and our thoughts are enlightened by you as we do deeds of justice. You have made us worthy to accept the life-giving passion of your only Son, who became for us the harbor of salvation. With the wise virgins we meet you with lighted lamps, filled with the oil of our good deeds, instead of the fading lamps which we hold now in our hands. In your glorious kingdom, you shall light the lamps of our souls with oil of love, purity of heart, serenity of conscience, and complete freedom. We shall offer glory to you, to your only Son, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
In the radiance of that day, Sea of mercy and compassion, in your abundant generosity and eternal kindness, you comfort those who grieve, suffer, and seek refuge in you. O harbor of safety and salvation, through this incense we now offer you, be a support and a savior to all those who came in true faith to the harbor of your holy church. As we commemorate your saving passion for us, we offer glory to you now and forever. Blow out your candles. All things hidden, revealed, all kinds of secrets will be known. What was said in secret, proclaim it in loud voice. What was darkness shall become light for you. I meditate upon the word of the Lord, hope for all generations.
A reading from the letter of Hebrews.
Glory to the Lord of Paul and the apostles. May the mercy of God descend upon the reader, the listeners, and upon this parish and her children forever.
Brothers and sisters, therefore, let us leave behind the basic teaching about Christ and advance to maturity, without laying the foundation all over again. Repentance from dead works and the faith in God, instruction about baptism and laying of on the hands, resurrection of the dead and eternal judgment. And we shall do this if only God permits. For it is impossible in the case of those who have once been enlightened and tasted the heavenly gift and shared in the Holy Spirit and tasted the good word of God and the power of the age to come, and then have fallen away, to bring them repentance again, since they are crucifying the Son of God for themselves and holding him up to contempt. Ground that has absorbed the water falling upon it repeatedly and brings forth crops useful for those whom it is cultivated receives a blessing from God. But if it produces thorns and thistles, it is rejected. It will soon be cursed and finally burned. But we are sure in your regard, beloved, of better things related to salvation, even though we speak in this way. Praise be to God always.
Alleluia.
Praise, glory, and honor. The most holy Trinity. For the proclamation of the gospel of our Savior, announcing life for our souls, we offer this incense and ask for your mercy, O Lord. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls. The Apostle Matthew writes, "And leaving them, Jesus went out of the city to Bethany, and there he spent the night. When he was going back to the city in the morning, he was hungry. And seeing a fig tree by the roadside, he went over to it, but he found nothing on it except leaves. And he said to it, 'May no fruit ever come from you again.' And immediately the fig tree withered. When the disciples saw this, they were amazed. And they said, 'How was it that the fig tree withered away immediately?' And Jesus said to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, if you have faith and do not waver, not only shall you do what you have seen done to the fig tree, but even if you say to this mountain, "Be lifted up and thrown into the sea," it shall be done. Whatever you ask for in prayer with faith, you shall receive.' And when he had come into the temple area, the chief priests and the elders of the people approached him as he was teaching. And they said, 'By what authority are you doing these things? And who gave you such authority?' And Jesus said to them in reply, 'I shall ask you one question, and if you answer it for me, then I shall tell you by what authority I do these things. From whence was John's baptism? Was it of heavenly or of human origin?'
And they discussed this among themselves, and they said, if we say of heavenly origin, he will say to us, then why did you not believe him? But if we say of human origin, we fear the crowd, for they all regard John as a prophet. And so they said to Jesus in reply, we do not know. And he himself said to them, then neither shall I tell you by what authority I do these things. This is the truth, peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, for giving us his word of life. Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God.
By what authority do you do these things? In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, amen. So as you can see, we talk about the opening up the entire week of Passion Week by this ceremony of the coming into the harbor. But in fact, it's very clearly about the end of the world. So you see how everything is overlapped in the Syriac tradition, that the death of our Lord, his descent into Sheol, and his coming on the day of glory are all juxtaposed, because in fact, they are all exactly the same thing from the perspective of God. They overlap. They all find their same origin in infinite wisdom, which is God. They all find their origin in God, which is also infinite charity. And so it's a lesson that we wind up learning of that simplicity, the healing of hearts, the magnificent cedro of the Husoyo ceremony. It is, as we begin this week of the Passion, for us to empty ourselves of ourselves and focus on nothing else other than the Passion of our Lord. That is the understanding. Throughout centuries, Holy Week and the week of Easter were really, if we ever talk about the thing of vacation, that was the only freedom that most people had for many centuries, was those 2 weeks basically off. Obviously, the farmers took care of what they had to take care of, but other than that, they were in church. And we were focusing upon that very foundation of the eternal love and the eternal wisdom which manifests itself in all of these different aspects. And in the Syriac tradition, of course, we are always oriented toward the Day of Judgment. This evening is very clear on that. And so this notion of the harbor of salvation is that we move towards Calvary because it moves us towards the Day of Judgment. Now in the Gospel, we see that very clearly this evening, because we see how the answer is calculated by the Pharisees and by the priests and the elders of the temple. Because when he asked him, he just simply asked them the question back, when they're asking, you're teaching. It is interesting to see that in the Gospels, our Lord is teaching in the temple every day until they arrest him. He's not hiding. He has come in on Palm Sunday, in this one moment of glory and joy. And then we're told that each day he goes to the temple and he keeps teaching. Sometimes interposed by strange things like the withering up of this fig tree. But he's always teaching there until he's arrested on Wednesday. And so when they ask this question, well, who are you to be here teaching these things? He gives us a magnificent lesson on the simplicity which it is to hear the word of God, to receive that word, to bring about the luminosity of the heart so that our actions flow from that light. And that's why he asked the priests, the elders, I ask you one question and then I'll answer you. And what we see them doing is completely the opposite of what our Lord expects from his disciples. But, unfortunately, what is very much in tune with the human heart, natural human heart. They calculate. They start muttering amongst themselves, figuring out, well, what answer are we going to give? So that when our Lord asked the question, well, was John the Baptist, was John a prophet? Was it from heaven, or is it just merely human? And you see them calculating with that whole answer by saying, well, if we say that it's from heaven, then he's going to say, well, then why didn't you listen to him? But if we say that it's purely human, the crowd will attack us. We'll have riots in the street because they thought he was a prophet. That's very much the way many people live religion. What's in it for me? What do I get out? What will the reaction be? And that's exactly what they're doing here, not in simplicity, but of multiplicity, of complexity, not of a simplicity of heart, which is moving towards healing and becoming luminous, but calculating. And so when they shrug their shoulders and went, I don't know, we're agnostics. That's the answer. Agnostic just simply means not knowing. We don't know. We are agnostics. And in that answer, then our Lord says, then I have nothing to say to you. And he answers nothing that they say. It's an important lesson. It's a simple exchange. But I have nothing to say to you because you have nothing to hear because you have closed your ears. And therefore you will learn nothing no matter what I say to you. And so he says, I will not answer your question. It is a great lesson for us of this simplicity of heart, that now as we enter into this week of the Passion of our Lord, that we ask for that profound simplicity. Simplicity is hard. It's like with St. Teresa of Lisieux. She calls her path of the life of the gospel the little way. But in fact, if you look at what she writes about, to do everything for the love of God, everything, from your prayers, of course, your assistance at Mass, of course, but the way in which you sweep the floor, the way in which you cut the grass, the way in which you change diapers, everything to be done for the love of God. So she calls it the little way because it's simple. But simple doesn't mean easy. Try doing it. That everything we do, do consciously from a luminous heart for the charity and love of God. And so it's the same thing here. When our Lord is asking us to enter with the simplicity of the luminosity of the heart, this image of the 10 bridesmaids, that five of them, all 10 of them fall asleep while they're waiting for the bridegroom to return. All 10, the wise and the foolish. The difference is that five of them have actually prepared for the future, and five of them have only lived in the present moment. And so that when our Lord returns, when the bridegroom returns in this parable, only five are ready to enter into the harbor of salvation. And so as we enter this week, let us ask our Lord to give us simplicity, ears to hear, eyes to see, and a great desire that all things be transfigured within us by the charity of God, so that what we have learned becomes luminous and the source of life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. So we will continue on with the colo. Same tone. O Christ the bridegroom, we came to meet you. O Lord our Lord, open for us. We ask you, beg you, and knock at your door. O Lord, open for us.
Hear us, O Lord, with the light of your kingdom.
We have heard your voice, O good shepherd. For the lambs of your flock, you are the door. O Lord, open for us.
Fill our hearts, Lord, with the light of your kingdom.
O Lord, gate of of mercies, open to those who knock, and ask for your saving grace. Lead us to the light of your eternal kingdom. We are the children of your church, and with our lamps lit we come to the church. As to the harbor of our salvation, we offer glory to you forever. So again, we'll divide one and two. Praise to him the night he saved us from our burdens. Trials and pain are over. Let us come and meet at the harbor, the living treasure, the true peace. That night the light covered earthly beings and heavenly ones. They all praise the Son of Light, the Maker of Light. In the world he brings safety to the harbor. That night the whole universe was inundated by light. Praise to the Son of Justice who sings in his church. His Spirit generously poured his love in the harbor. Praise to you, O Son of the Father, for your passion. Praise to you, O Father of truth. Praise to you, O Spirit of holiness. You are one God, a Trinity. You are light, most exalted above all lights. The Bo'uto is a finishing prayer that we have, and normally what we finish with our prayers, you have them in this ramsho, the evening office, these supplications. So Bo'uto de Mora, Mora is saint, so you have Bo'uto supplication de Mora Ephraim of Saint Ephraim. Maronite raham alein. In the middle of the night they cry,
wake up the bridegroom is coming.
In their hands they hold lamps filled with oil,
like a warm light in their face,
and their heart like a burning fire. Maronite raham alein.
Foolishness has its own face, an empty lamp void of oil. The heart of the foolish burdens, trembled at the waking call. O Lord, our night has no end, nor our foolishness. Do not let us meet you with an empty lamp.
Maronite raham alein. In the lamp, in the need of oil, light dies. To the needy heart, open, O Lord, your treasure, and may my lamp, during the night of my life, remain lit, that immersed in light, I may praise you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us adore, praise, and thank and praise the most holy and glorious Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie Lord, Compassion in the abundance of your grace. You give rest to the weary, relief to those who struggle, and support and protection to those who seek refuge in you. O harbor of safety and of salvation, save all those who in true faith reach the harbor of your holy church. We offer glory and thanksgiving to you, now and forever.